I wouldn't rush to put Patterson in the team. You know, I like Tavernier, and I think, you know, based he's a captain, he's a leader. But if Steven Gerrard, for whatever reason, thinks that Tavernier isn't hitting the mark, then he does have a ready-made replacement. But I'm not going to jump on a bandwagon because Rangers have dropped a couple. Yeah, we know that Rangers haven't been playing well, but it's collectively as a team. Like we said, if Alfredo Morelos is his shooting boots on this game last season, Rangers were 3 or 4 up, the game was over, and we wouldn't be talking about Tavernier. So is Tavernier one guy that should be put out of the team? No. I understand there's a clamour because Nathan Patterson is an excellent young player, and he's Scottish and he's from the academy, and it's all those boxes that get ticked. But I think to single out James Tavernier, I'm not going to go on that bandwagon just now. I think that's unfair.
Jason?
I'm not singling him out. All I'm saying is I'm a big Tavernier fan. He's captain of the club. He's obviously took us back to where every Rangers fan's been looking to get to for the past 10 years. But what my point was is that, you know, if the manager's coming out week in, week out, saying, you know, if you get your chance, you know, go on, show it, you can take it and make that jersey yours. In my opinion, any time that I've seen Patterson playing the Rangers jersey this season compared to Tavernier, and I'm not singling him out, because there's been a lot of players on that park that you know, haven't played up to the standards that we know they're capable of. I feel like Nathan Patterson has played, in my opinion, far superior to Tavernier over the course of what he's shown for this season. So I think to myself, if we're saying, you know, your chances are given to you and you take them on your performance levels, surely that would mean Patterson would get ahead of Tavernier. That was more the point I was trying to make.
Yeah, no, I get that, Jason, but also as well, that has Tavernier played that badly that he deserves to lose the jersey? So bearing in mind, you know, you look at what Tavernier has contributed to the football club, and I know it's all about the here and now, I get that, but I think part of why you're saying that and part of why there seems to be a bit of momentum going here for partners in is because he's Scottish and because he's coming through. I'm not saying he's not a good player.
He's bang on form.
Yeah, he's a right good player, but it's also as well, every day in training, we're not seeing it. Steven Gerrard is seeing every day in training too. And I just think for Tavernier to be singled out or in the eyes of some people, a scapegoat, you know, I don't think that's fair. Just as I would say, it would be totally unfair to leave Alan McGregor out on Thursday night because he's the howler on Saturday afternoon.
Barry, what would you say about Nathan Patterson and Tavernier? It's the same position, I suppose. That's why.
Well, in terms of Tavernier, he came through this same, not as bad as it is just now, but I think if you remind it back 2 years ago, there was a lot of critics, and that's one thing that gained my respect with James Tavernier. He made himself available. He still went out there. He played and he came through it. For me just now, I think he's too important a player. Understand the clamour for Nathan Patterson. I'm a massive fan of him. I think in time that will become his position 100%, but at this moment in time, I would stick with James Tavernier. First captain, he's a leader of the group. He's like everybody, he's not hitting top form, but that will come in time. It's an issue when you've got two fantastic fullbacks. It's an issue, but it's a great issue to have.
But you wonder, does something give then in January with that? Because if Patterson's not getting a game and there's interest in them, you know, there's big
Everton
interest in them from down south, yeah. So therefore, again, do you think, well, we're keeping James Tavernier, so therefore, Nathan, we don't want to let him go, but if we're getting good money, it allows to go and revitalise, re-energise, replenish the squad, or likewise, if over the next week or two, Steven Gerrard decides, no, do you want, no, I'm going with Patterson. Come what may, I'm giving him a run in the team now, who's going to be my number one? Then Tavernier's nose would obviously bound a joint, and then does he become somebody that might be...
I would hate to see them cash in on Nathan Patterson in January. I would. I think it's important for his development, Mark, as well, that he goes and plays consistently for a year or two. You see so many young boys go and leave a club only playing 15, 20 games, and they don't really kick on at the next club. I think it's, for Nathan Patterson's development, I think it's important for him to stay and try and get as much game time as he can. It's going to be difficult, but that's a great one. Come January, it might be Tavernier that he might have to look at. Two fantastic fullbacks in my eyes. It's a great problem to have as a manager.